So the first portion of this video was recorded on June 19th, 2023. Overall, Mia is still quite reluctant to move here.
So you see how much more upright she looks in the front now from before? And it's not going to stay there forever. She's going to take, you know, some time of building the posture and musculature to stay there. Sort of. She's like, I think so, but my head is still going the wrong way.
So is that just to see if she would respond to the reins?
So
or?
Yeah, you want to see if they understand, again, this isn't something you train, but can she follow the feel of the rein without the human over there? So I should just have to do that and she should come around.
Gotcha.
There, my head and neck goes this way. This is the way that I go. Again, part of that's baby stuff, but part of it is just that I'm conscious of the human thing. Okay. Over here.
She has a tendency to throw her head up a lot and does that in response, I think, to anticipating being corrected for coming into your space.
Very hard for leading from the other side. Mm-hmm. And you, so you see why, how important it is to do both sides, because she'd rather run into my back than make that turn. Mm-hmm. And the trotting is just to get her to follow me and keep the flow wherever I go. So if I go this fast, she better get up there. And if I stop, like, she should stop. Good. So in the beginning, you make stuff just really public. Like you're having a Tourette's attack. Good. So that was actually a good thought. Because I don't want it to be about this telling her get back. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's times that I'll use that as a tool, but I ultimately want her to respond to me. Take a step back so she has a space to come in. I use the rope to direct her, and then when I want her to go out again, I have to start walking forward with her. Because if I keep backing up, she's going to keep coming towards me because that's drawing her in. But if her head is where it's meant to be, see how she's just going to keep coming in. Mm-hmm. In. In. So we want to go out. Be straight or over the inside shoulder. She can't be bending out away, or she's just looking for a way to get into trouble. Good girl. What I want her to learn to come back off of is this. If she can't do that, I don't want to get on. She does not understand how to stop without her jaw being pulled. So the problem with that is when you pull back on the reins, most people are taught to pull back to stop. Excuse you, no, you still have to pay attention. You're the star of the show. Even in a necropsy, it locks the stifle joint. That's why it stops some horses.
Oh.
But it's like putting your truck in reverse on the freeway or something. I mean, it's just braking something to make it stop. Mm-hmm. And so a horse should stop when you do this. So you just stop riding. Because riding should be an active activity. Excuse you. Back. 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 So again, she's just really unconscious of the human. So it's good that she... said it's not spooky, but see, now she's leaning on this foreleg.
Yeah.
Well, let me rotate to the other one. And so I go forward from it. Good girl. That was better. The shoulders are what we need to lighten up. Do you see how much force you have to use if you want her to follow you?
Yeah.
And that is not what we want. Especially with a bit in her mouth. Can you imagine if you're riding her and she decides to disagree?
Yeah, that's
then
not nice.
You have to keep yourself safe, but you don't want to be pulling on their mouth. Okay. Nothing. So So that's like pretty much dead. There we go. Get a little more reaction even on the saddle from the sound than the pop on the wither.
This second half of the video was filmed on July 14th.
All right, so you discovered, as talked about, that this horse really wants to, excuse me, push through the human. But I noticed yesterday she really holds her breath when she's working. And so we had a little breakthrough around that, and her demeanor did improve considerably. So one of the things that I'm gonna ask her to do that she's really struggled with is to be able to change directions while still moving. So we got to where we can sort of do that, but I'd like to put it together a little more like a song today. So it'll be interesting just to see what she does. If we have an emergency itch, which we will address accordingly. All right. The space for her to move around, but especially with a horse like this, if we start flogging her to go, she's just gonna get more angry. She wants to roll, but we'll do that after. Come on. So if you are gonna use the whip, if you go around the hind end and catch the opposite, that is a herding effect and it's less of a whipping effect. I don't care about that face. Keep going. Good. She went to blowing right away, which was really a good thing. She's always willing to stop forward and change direction. We're going to see if we can get that going a little better. Holding her breath. There, you can see that, the way she's holding her lips so tight. Mm-hmm. It may not show up on the film, but just as an awareness. Thank you. Anything stepping over that isn't coming at you right now is a victory.
Just briefly revisiting this exercise from the previous portion of the video. As I said before, we don't really train this, it's just a checkpoint.
So you see how we were able to keep the float that time?
Uh-huh.
I didn't have to pull. That's the first time she's ever come forward without
pulling,
having to pull on some level. So that's a huge, huge, huge thing. I'm going to let her roll now. She